the U.S. Air National Guard Air Force Reserve Command Test Center, or AATC, has revealed that it had tested a new variant of the AGM-114 Hellfire missile. The new type is named AGM-114R-4. The main upgrade in this variant is it has a much longer range. The missile was tested from an MQ-9 Reaper. This is a crucial development and has significant tactical implications. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the new AGM-114R-4 Hellfire missile is a substantial boost for the MQ-9 Reaper. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. As per reports, AATC led the test of the missile during this year's biennial Valiant Shield exercise held in June. The test was reportedly also meant to evaluate the system's associated weaponeering software. The AATC has stated that AGM-114R-4 can fly roughly 3 times as far as earlier variants of the missile. The press release read, "The AATC MQ-9 test detachment was supported by the 174th Attack Wing with Block 5 MQ-9 aircraft. The 556th Test and Evaluation Squadron supported with a Block 30 ground control station, while test flights were flown out of Creech Air Force Base using Air Combat Command (ACC), Air National Guard (ANG), and Air Force Special Operations Command (AFSOC) aircrew. AATC stated that AGM-114R-4s would provide the drone with the ability to engage threats while maintaining a safe distance out of the threat's ability to counterstrike, which is crucial in survivability in a contested environment. The AGM-114 Hellfire is an air-to-ground missile, AGM, first developed for anti-armor use, later developed for precision drone strikes against other target types, especially high-value targets. It was originally developed under the name Helleborn Laser Fire and Forget Missile, which led to the colloquial name Hellfire, ultimately becoming the missile's formal name. It has a multi-mission, multi-target precision strike ability and can be launched from multiple air, sea, and ground platforms. Most variants are laser-guided, with one variant, the AGM-114L Longbow Hellfire, being radar-guided. Depending on the variant, it has a maximum speed of Mach 1.3 and a maximum range of 7 miles, or about 11 kilometers. The AGM-114R-4 variant is thought to have a range of 21 miles in ideal conditions, so technically it has 3 times the range. On March 9, 2018, the U.S. Air Force officially retired Predator, a platform that initiated a new era of unmanned air combat. Predators were best known for their ability to deliver precision strikes as their controllers sat halfway around the world in small and discreet bunkers. Reaper brings much more to the table when compared to Predator. Reaper has an endurance of 27 hours, a service ceiling of 50,000 feet, a range of 1,151 miles or 1,852 kilometers, and a max speed of 300 miles per hour or 482 kilometers per hour. The U.S. Air Forces are in the process of attaching extended range, or ER, upgrade kits for almost all the Reapers. With the ER kit, Reapers have an endurance of up to 42 hours without external stores. Reaper's main sensor is the nose-mounted MTS-B multispectral surveillance and targeting turret, and its fuselage-mounted Lynx synthetic aperture radar. But Reaper's pylons are very versatile and can be used to carry a variety of tactical equipment, like communications relay hops, electronic warfare pods, as well as wide area aerial surveillance (WAS) camera arrays. The additional sensors are designed to act in conjunction with the drone's main sensors. The USAF has put more potent radars on board some Reapers. The idea is to create ground-moving targeting identification (GMTI) sensor nodes that can be dispersed around the war zone. GMTI is a radar capability that can be used to trail moving targets on the ground over time using radar. Reaper has been a crucial platform for the global war on terror. It's worked very well when being used against adversaries that don't have sophisticated counters like terrorist organizations. But when employed against more technically well-equipped rivals, it's vulnerable, and one of the major issues is its short strike envelope. Viewers may note that the US Air Force is considering scaling back Reaper operations due to this. With AGM-114R-4, the drone's standoff range would be significantly enhanced, and this could add second life to the Reaper. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.